Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to be creating a collage space painting.
Materials for this project include newspaper laid out at your workstation, white paint container that you'll share at your table, white pencil, big large brush, not a small detailed one, and a black piece of paper.
Start by taking a white colored pencil and writing your name on the back of the paper. Once you're done, flip it over and begin to splatter paint. When you're splatter painting, take the shared white paint, brush it off on your brush, and then put your thumb on the brush and flick downward. You're pulling your thumb towards yourself to allow the paint to flick towards the paper. Please make sure you're targeting the black paper, and if you miss a little bit, you should have the newspaper underneath it to catch. Do not flick towards anybody else or anything other than the newspaper or the black piece of paper.
Next, choose a couple pieces of paper to use for your planets for your space drawing. You're going to need 2 to 3 colored pieces of paper.
Next, choose a template and trace it on the corner of your paper. This allows you to make a perfect circle and also conserve paper by using the corner so it can be reused later. You can do this for several pieces of paper. And again, share your paper and reuse it later on for other people with other colors.
When you're choosing your oil pastel colors, please correspond it to the paper color itself. For example, blue goes really good with dark to medium to light blue. Purple goes really good with pink to magenta to purple. Red, orange, and yellow go good with purple to red to orange to yellow. And green goes really well with a dark blue to dark green to light green, or even a yellow as well. So stick with that range when you're oil pasteling.
Once you've chosen your oil pastels, you can start to blend. I'm gonna start with an orange here on this yellow piece of paper, going in a spiral or radial pattern, going from dark or heavy pressure from the outside to lighter pressure as I go towards the center. You wanna lighten the pressure to lighten the range of color. Then I'm gonna switch to a yellow. The yellow, I'm gonna push hard on the center and work my way out to the outside. I'm still gonna apply a pretty hard pressure with the yellow because it's a lot lighter in color and a lot less dominant. That's gonna allow it to blend a little bit more efficiently. Once you're done adding your colors, you're going to smear with a spiral pattern or circular pattern with a paper towel. On this technique, I'm going more up and down, kind of lines a lot longitude, kind of, if you're thinking of it like a globe. So going vertical and then curving to each side, to the right and then to the left. Again, I'm using like a light teal color, and then I'm switching to a darker, kind of more of a medium blue here from the center and then lightly to the edge to the right. And then I'm gonna switch to the darkest blue starting from the right and then going very lightly to the left. Again, you're trying to create a nice range or gradient of color, yet still making sure that the colors blend gradually using paper towels to smear those together. For this final technique, I'm using another spiral or radial pattern, but this time I'm focusing on one circle kind of off the top right and then doing like a rippling effect out from that area. I'm going dark on the inside, heavy pressure, and then a lot lighter as I go towards the outside. Now I'm ready to switch to a little bit of a more of a medium green. I tested it on my paper and I'm still spiraling out from that spot. So I'm gonna continue to fill in the green throughout the edge. Again, applying this on top of the light green. And then once you fill that in with the medium green, you can switch to a darker color, maybe a blue. Blue's next to green on the color wheel, so that would make sense. I'm filling that in and then gently and lightly going on top of my greens with that blue, because blue is much more dark and much more dominant. So don't overdo it, just do a little bit of a gradient. And then I'm going back with that medium green on top of the blue and then bringing that a little bit closer into the lighter green. And then I'm gonna switch that light green one more time. When I switch to the light green, I'm gonna apply that on top of the medium green and on top of the blue, and that's gonna help to smear in so it's a gradient of color. When you're doing all of these oil pastels, you're really trying to eliminate the lines and try to make it just tonal, meaning it gradually changes. The paper towel is the final step to make all of your colors blend seamlessly together. Next, you're cutting out the shapes that you just drew in oil pastel. When you're cutting these out, make sure that you cut just within the pencil lines so they're not visible. That way that you won't see any of the flaws or imperfections. Cut right to the oil pastel line, and then when you're done, you're ready to glue. Before you start gluing down your planets and your shapes, I want you to think about composition. First, if there's any imperfections on your splatter painting, you might consider hiding those with your different shapes. Also, I want you to show depth by overlapping one or several of your planets in front or behind each other. Also, leave a margin. Don't put a planet right next to the edge of your paper, and also think about light source. Next, you're gonna be adding a thin line of glue, not a lot, just a thin amount of glue. I would do one ring on the edge, then another ring or two lightly on the inside. Place the planet on your piece of paper, adding a little bit of pressure with your hand, and then flip it over and rub more firmly on the backside. That allows you to keep from smearing the oil pastel.